Let me give you a classic example about myself. I run a successful business. Success became boring because when I wake up and I get to my office, I start sleeping in my office. Why? I have my deputy who has signed all the checks. I have my deputy who has approved everything. He just gives me a report. So there's nothing I do. So instead of the energy to move, I begin to sleep. I begin to slack because everything has been done. Invoices are paid. Bills are paid. There was nothing. I was not thinking anymore because everything has been sorted out. Once things begin to get sorted out and then you don't need to think anymore, complacency has set in.
So in this time, I said I wanted to rebuild myself. I had 47 cars, 16 were Range Rovers. I started dashing the Range Rovers out. I said, God that helped me here will help me again. So I started noticing that certain things were happening to me. Certain things were disturbing me. The things that I was excited about, no more excited me. I started feeling like Elijah. That it's easy for me to walk with short knicker and walk up and down. I have made money before. I will always make money. Na lie. I have succeeded before. I will succeed again. Na lie. Between two mountains of success, there is a valley of failure. Whenever you go up a mountain of success, you are coming down a valley of failure. The signs that you are at the beginning of failure is what they call here. Is complacency. You take things as normal. You meet only 10,000. You meet maybe 100,000 this month. Next month, 100,000. The month after, 80,000 or 2 million. Let's go 2 million. You do 3 million, then you go to 2.5 million. You do 3 million, 2.5 million, you are still there. You have gotten to your complacency level. You cannot think further than that. So, because of that, the market share that is available will come and attack what you have. Then you start going down, okay, 1.8 million. We'll strive again, 1.2 million. You are going down. You are going down. Failure. And I tell people that whether you like it or not, the law of gravity will always take place. Whatever goes up must come down. So, if in life you have painstakingly gone up, you are going to come down. It is normal. Now, the only thing that happens is that if you go down, you are supposed to go back up. True or false? False. Nothing in life guarantees you go back up again. There are people that have gone, that have succeeded, and then they have failed. To go back up is not possible. Because there are two things that happen to them. One is that they meet like two sisters. Two sisters. Sister A is called money. Sister B is called wisdom. Both of them are twin sisters. It is important you understand the wisdom before the money comes. Because if you understand money before wisdom comes, you will be abused. Sister B is a very jealous girl. Wisdom is jealous. If Sister B sees that you go for wisdom, for money first, she will say, when money deals with you, you will come and look for her. How do you know when money has dealt with you? I used to have money before. Know that wisdom has dealt with you. She has taught you a lesson. You will now come here. What wisdom does? Wisdom gives you friends. Wisdom gives you insight. Gives you exposure. Gives you training. That's all. And at the end, she will introduce you to money. So what happens is that if somebody knows wisdom first, you will be climbing like this. And you will know in future that you need to build a bridge across here. From one success to the next one. But if you go to meet money first, money will allow you to climb up. The higher you go, the deeper the fall. The minute you buy a new car, that car is outdated. So you need to build a bridge. That bridge is people. So along the way, begin to get people who becomes like your lieutenant, your support. So that they can do that. And I said something. Why do the work of 10 men when you can give 10 men the work to do? Develop capacity in this one. capacity in this world. So when you need to, you can delegate properly. When you cannot delegate, you cannot go far. That's when complacency sets in. So you build a bridge, and your bridge is people. So as you build people, because if in 3 months, what you sow, because that means 3 months of business, you do business now, you collect the money, you cash out. You cash out. It's corn. Poor people. 1 year. If you want results in 3 months, plant corn. If you want results in a year, plant yam. You will eat it. You will roast it. You will fry it. But if you want result of a lifetime, plant men. So it is men that carry you from one mountain to the other mountain. They would have told her, this our guy is good. He knows how to behave himself. He has ethics. He's the one that showed us the path. They were the one that will recommend you to your next level. But if you chop alone, you go up and you scatter. And I tell everybody, along the way, make sure you start carrying people early. Start carrying people early. Start carrying people early. And do penetration tests, loyalty tests. Because at a certain point, you will need them to cross to your next level of success. If the bridge is weak, you are going to fall down. And if God help you, you are crashing immediately. So you need to build that bridge. You need to build people to be able to prepare for your future.
You need a new challenge. So I said, no. Let me stand aside from my business. Let me retire from my business and go and do something new. So I took a new challenge, how to turn younger people into it. Now, I tell a classic example. 1 times 1 million is equal to 1 million. 1 million times 1 is equal to 1 million. But there's a difference. One time, like you have one client that pays you 1 million naira, that's one person. But if you have 1 million people to pay you 1 naira, the experience is totally different. Yes, it's totally different. So if you have that, you need to know how do you convince one person to pay you 1 naira or another person. So you must understand the strategy of the market you're entering, how you're working in it, and how you're able to convince somebody. 1 times 1 million is one market share, 100%. So if that person stops paying you, you have lost everything. So you need to check in the area of your whether your industry or your relationship, you're gone. How do you stay relevant? It's cool. As we are getting older, our body shapes are changing, so you are no more as attractive as before, but you can be a mentor to people. You can also, that's how you do. You metamorphose according to your changes, your age, and every single thing.